We're at the church of St. Demetrius in the town of Ruza,
where martyr Pavel Sokolov served.
Martyr Pavel Sokolov was born on the 3rd of March 1892 in the county town of Ruza, Moscow province. His father Sergei Gavrilovich served as a psalmist to the church of great martyr Demetrius of Thessalonica, and his mother Ekaterina Stepanovna was raising up five children. In 1912 Sergei Gavrilovich Sokolov became a deacon, and in 1917 he was ordained a priest and served to a ripe old age. According to the NKVD questionnaire, in 1938, at the age of 75, Father Sergius was still serving in the village of Dubrava of Ruza district. Both brothers of Pavel Sergeyevich, Sr. Alexander and Jr. Nikolai, in different years graduated from the Bethany Theological Seminary. Pavel Sokolov himself finished Volokolamsk Spiritual College and in August 1906 also entered Bethany Spiritual Seminary, where he studied until May 1914. In March 1914, along with other students of the 6th grade, he was blessed to wear a stikerion. At the end of the seminary course, he declared his desire to serve in the ecclesiastical department. I will have residence in the house of my parent, the deacon of the Dmitrov Church of the town of Ruza, Sergei Sokolov. During the Civil War, psalmist Pavel Sokolov was mobilized to Rey Militia, being demobilized shortly after, and he continued to live in the town of Ruza. There he served as a psalmist until he was arrested in 1938, bearing all the hardships of a servant of the persecuted church, poverty, extortion, persecution by the authorities. Pavel Sokolov obeyed, even though he was blind in one eye. According to the NKVD questionnaire in 1934, Pavel Sokolov was deprived of voting rights by the presidium of the council of the town of Ruza and restored to civil rights only after the constitution was approved in 1937. Meanwhile, from 1924 to 1937, Pavel Sergeyevich was taxed with the firm task on meat and milk delivery. Pavel Sokolov was arrested on the 10th of February 1938 on charges of conducting active counter-revolutionary agitation and was imprisoned in the Ruza District Police Station. In the detention order it was pointed out, being alien to the Soviet authorities and party, he systematically agitated among the population in anti-Soviet way, trying to disrupt the arranged events. Speaking among the faithful about the elections to the Supreme Soviet, Sokolov declared, "According to the new law, even clergymen can be elected, so we need to nominate our priest as a candidate to the Supreme Soviet, while we, the faithful, should agitate among the population not to vote for communists. Moreover, among collective farmers he agitates against kolkhoz, saying, no matter how long you work on collective farms, nothing will work. While no matter how good is the harvest, the authorities will take everything from you. You'll live worse on collective farms than during the serfdom. A peasant will live badly until Soviet authorities exist. If you want to live better, you need to eliminate these authorities." In the indictment of psalmist Pavel Sokolov it was written, "In October 1937, being in the town council of Ruza, he said to the clerk of the town council Alexeyev, what a life we have now. We are knuckled under Soviet authorities. It is impossible to live. Despite the church is separated from the state, it is heavily taxed anyway. The church became more poor. That is why not many faithful go to it. Early church income was bigger. We lived much better than during the Soviet regime." Being questioned as an indicted, Sokolov Pavel Sergeyevich categorically denied the charge of counter-revolutionary agitation. By a decision of the NKVD Troika on the 16th of February 1938, Pavel Sokolov was sentenced to death by firing squad. Psalmist Pavel Sokolov was executed on the 26th of February 1938 on Butva firing range area near Moscow and was buried in an unmarked mass grave. In August 2000, Martyr Pavel Sokolov was canonized by the Archbishop Council of the Russian Orthodox Church.